Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Mr. Electron, and today I'm going to teach you the most efficient way to produce hydrogen oxygen flame at home. So guys, we are going to need a tape, okay? After completing the taping process comes the second part, which is electrical isolation, okay? So this is the part, this is one of the parts to be specific. Done. Now comes the isolation, electrical isolation of this. So the electrical isolation has completed. Now comes the head part. Okay. Now I have taken a tighter belt to further prevent the air from escaping from the sides. Okay. Now guys, on this pressure cooker cover, I have also placed black insulation tape. Okay. Now why I have done that, you will understand it later in the video. And here, as you can see, the rubber belt that is also placed here. And this part is done. Now comes our 12 volts UPS battery. This needs to be recovered and needs a lot of charging. I haven't used it, I haven't charged it for almost 8 or 9 months. Okay, so guys, it's time to open all the knobs to see about the water level and then start the recharging process. Well guys, here I'm using rainwater, okay, and there are a few slots in which there is very less water. Okay, one second. Yeah, you see no water in this one, but water is present in this one, and again no water in this one and this one. So I will have to fill that out. Now guys, here what you see is a triangular metallic piece, okay? So I need it for the conduction of electricity and this pin for connecting to one of the terminals of the UPS battery, okay? So I am going to choose the negative terminal of the battery, okay? This one is the negative terminal. So I've connected to the negative and it is going to come below the battery, like battery is going to reside on it. So guys, after doing the connections, you are going to need one more pin for the positive terminal, but we will connect that later. So let's remove the wooden board, not needed anymore. And now we need is the pressure cooker itself. This is also not needed. So it's simple enough. Place the metal sheet, you see this metal piece, below it and keep the battery. Yeah, battery is in place. And guys, I've placed this metal sheet this way because I need the negative of the battery, you see, to get in contact electrically with this part of the cooker, okay? And this side is still open, okay? Let's do the connection for this one. So guys, this is the cooker cap, and now what you have to do is use some sieving machine oil and place it on the belt. This further prevents the air from leaking, okay? Yeah, done. So with that being done, comes the part of placing this wire. Sorry, the oil is getting leaked. So guys, I will quickly show you because the oil starts leaking up. I have placed the wire over here, and now what I have to do is connect this terminal to the positive terminal of the battery, okay? And this is a little tricky because the negative has been connected to this part and positive has been connected to this part, and for that reason I placed this insulation tape over here and here to prevent any short circuit. I am electrically isolating this pressure cooker piece and this piece, okay? So that's why I've also placed tape over here and here, just a precaution. And after that, connect it like this. Yeah, this has connected successfully. Now what we can see is this part of the pressure cooker is the negative, okay, and this part, the head part, is the positive. Okay, now a little bit careful. Okay, so this is completely locked. Now guys, to make sure that there is no short circuit condition, what I'm going to do is measure the voltage. So I've pointed it to 12 volts DC mode, and now I'm going to touch these pins to the cooker to see the battery voltage. Here, as you can see, that it is showing the full voltage, indicating that there is no short circuit occurrence. So guys, to the nozzle, as you can see, I have connected a pipe, and this is the end exit point. And the point is to collect the gas in this balloon. So taking the balloon and placing it like this, and using a plastic rope, well, you can use whatever you want, at least that is what I am doing, to tighten up the balloon, okay? It is very important because the pressure might just blow it away. Done. Now it's time to charge the battery. Remember that this side is positive and this is negative, as I told you before, the connection part. And guys, 15 volts, 3 amperes charger is what I'm going to use here. You can see output 15V, 3A, and input of 100 to 240 volts, okay? Laptop charger. And these are the two terminals. White one is positive and black one is negative. Little rusty because I've been using it on a sulfuric acid. So it has corroded, but still works. Now guys, there is a place over here, a little groove. I'm going to connect the negative to that point. You see, connected. Successfully, now the positive is left. The top head is positive, so I'm going to connect the positive to the top head. Okay, done. At present, the connection seems fine. Everything seems fine. You can see that there's a little inflation of hydrogen gas. Even when it is not charging, it still produces hydrogen oxygen gas. But yes, the truth is that we need a lot more than that. Okay, so here I'm going to turn on the switch and you should see some change. You can see that the balloon is inflating little by little and a bit more than before. Very soon it is going to enter the recovery mode. Current is a little more than before. It is 0.23. A lot more current is needed for fast filling of balloon with air. Although you can see that it is inflating, but taking a lot of time. Well guys, after a time period of about half an hour or 45 minutes, this balloon inflated like this, as you can see. Here I have also made this nozzle for the flame. So let's carefully take it out from there and place it over here and then see how good the flame is. Well guys, the bad news is that the balloon burst out while placing this at the balloon's opening. So I think I will have to do this again with another balloon. Well guys, it took around 20 more minutes and you can see that it is inflated this much. I think I should continue with the experiment before I fill it up completely and then it blasts. Yeah, now it seems fine. Whoa, you see? Pretty good flame. You see, good flame. Whoa, what is this? You see, it is like it is traveling.